So, ladies and... Well, hold on. So, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our video of spine and karma. Okay, this is very important. And this is the question that was asked today by one of my followers. And they said, this is from Andrea H. And she says, how can one evolve spiritually through the spine? As the seat of major energy, meridians, chakras, and neurons, the spinal cord defines the quality of our life in the womb. The spine is the first thing that is formed, and then the body, limbs, takes roots. Can you please elaborate? So, of course, do you know this is the reason why Mercury actually becomes the most crucial, the most important planet? See, most people are running around fearing about Rahu, Ketu, Saturn, Mars. Nobody fears about Mercury. Mercury can give... When Mercury, you know, frowns, I mean, it's kind of like just getting constant shocks in life. Mercury is the spine and the nervous system. Now, of course, one thing I'll say right away is that I am not going to show you any technique regarding about karmas and the burning of them through the spine, because I have taken the oath of secrecy of certain technique to do certain things. Now, why is it that, you know, because I'll tell you that even I felt a little bit taken aback by somebody very close to me that I asked. Actually, I asked several people. I'm like, hey, can you show me this technique? You know, like, for example, of Kriya Yoga. Okay, I'm like, can you just give it to me? I've been looking for it. No one's here to give me. And then pandemic happens. And they said, no, I can't. You're going to have to find someone. I can't. Why is it that? Because number one, you shouldn't even look for it from anybody out there. Due to the fact only a specific person has the energy to power everything for you. See, here's the thing. I can give you the technique. Anybody can give you the technique. And you can start doing the technique and it will not work. It will not work. You will not feel anything. The reason being, if I gave you, it's like you have a cell phone, right? You have a cell phone which is really brand new. Everything is brand new. Okay? And it's turned off. There's no battery charged in it. What use is that cell phone? So you can read about a cell phone, right? In a book of Patanjali, in the book of Patanjali, the Ashtanga Yoga, you can read about iPhone, right? You can read about the iPhone. And suddenly you found the iPhone. Okay, well, if it's like not turned on like this, I think it'll make a nice coaster, you know, for my coffee in the morning. And that's about it. So the information you will read from some book about this technique of spine is just like having a cell phone with no charge. What guru does, only specific gurus who are allowed to and are permitted to do this, what they do is they plug the wire in, suddenly the phone turns on, okay? And also you get the Wi-Fi connection. So now you can download apps, you can go online, and you can have the world at your feet. This is why, and I've seen people who question this actually in lectures and all that. You know, like, hey, Patanjali has given this already. So why do we need to do this or come here? It's exactly that reason why. Not everybody, you're supposed to be seeking it. You can just read it in a magazine and just look at it as some entertainment. No, this is a lifelong practice. And, you know, it cannot be charged by yourself. If I give you something which is not charged, it's useless. If I give you a Tesla that has no battery and no ability to charge, it's nothing. It's like a couch with doors. So that's the first thing I want to say. But the karma and spine becomes very important because, of course, as you know about the chakra system, you know, from the root chakra all the way to the 1,000-petal lotus chakra, the way to go from the bottom to the top is by burning off the karmas. This section, you could have the karma related to your family. Here is the karma related to work. You know, here could be the karma related to love. So what these certain techniques allow you, okay, is that instead of dealing with them slowly, 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 by doing certain exercise, by doing certain breathings, what's happening is, one by one, these microscopic electric currents starts dissipating. That were just like buzzing, because they were buzzing, because that was unfinished karma. They start to diffuse themselves. Slowly, slowly, what happens is, when the electric currents are diffused enough and have cleared the pathway into the spine, suddenly they talk about that whole Sushumna Nadi becoming active. And this is, and especially you will see with the pending karmas that you have, right? Pending karma is seen from the 6th, 8th, and 12th house and their lords, especially their lords. When, as soon as those things get finished off, suddenly you will see that a person gets interested, you know, in higher knowledge and spirituality. If somebody automatically does it naturally without ever meeting an astrologer, ever watching any YouTube videos, you know, it's not like you, unless you watch some video of mine, only then you're going to be able to pay your pending karma off. No, the reason why you're born is so you can finish the pending karma off. Even if it's to simply go to foreign lands and get educated and meet someone and get your heart broken, that was a pending karma. Finished. Now, that could happen in your 20s, that may happen in your 50s. But when these certain amount of karmas get burnt out, then the soul feels free to ascend to the higher. It's like the prison of the karma was holding it. And yes, like you said, there are these, especially these murmur points. Like, and remember, the thing about, you know, chakras, you know, the chakra clinging, sometimes what happens is you'll have to take your root chakra from the bottom to the top. You might have to take it from bottom to this part to work something out. There, this thing goes so deep that, you know, I'm not qualified to talk about it. But what I am qualified to talk about is how this is kind of connecting with astrology, is connecting with Mercury number one. You will see, the moment you start doing certain practices, it first will impact your Mercury. Mercury suddenly becomes alive. Why? Because if you're working on your spine, like for example, when you get into a relationship, what becomes active? Venus, 7th house, it becomes active. Wherever Venus is placed, now suddenly those things are also becoming active. So relationship comes in, but also at the same time, you're having fight with your mother. Why? Because Venus activated itself. It's like, oh, you suddenly are now in a relationship with somebody? Okay, I got to do what I have to do. Same way, Mercury becomes activated. Mercury, see, a child is speaking. Mercury is a child, youth. See? And she's saying the name Kriti, which is Kritika, the cutting of the karmas. Omen, guys, omen. So what's happening is, by doing Kriya Yoga, every time you do a particular, whether it's Kriya, whether it's something else, if it's somehow connected with the spine, which all yogas are, you're activating your Mercury. And what you're doing in that activation of Mercury, you're specifically paying those mercurial karmas off. Mercurial karmas are the most important karma, because originally from the sign of Aries, Mercury is ruling the 6th house of Prarabdha karma. The karma that is the main reason behind our birth. It is why you're born to deal with it. And especially the more you do this Kriya, what happens is Mercury's essence becomes lighter and lighter and lighter. And also it starts ascending Mercury, okay, from the sign of Virgo, where you're starting your Kriya, and it takes Mercury to the sign of Pisces. Now, you may call it debilitation. Debilitation is kind of like, you know, the problem is, in Sanskrit, the word niche can mean 20 different things. When we translate this into English, becomes niche as in debilitated, as in weak, as in bad. We don't get that. And I can't tell you how many countless of people I have who have attained their PhDs with debilitated Mercury. So please don't look at it that way. What it shows, Mercury will have to leave its exaltation that it has on Earth. Okay, because when it's in Earth, because Virgo is an Earth sign, this is where the lower level of intelligence is exalted. Taking care of paperwork, taking care of administrative work, learning your mathematics, learning your physics. These are all lower forms of that intelligence. And this is where Mercury is exalted, because it's supposed to be on Earth. This is why it's that Earth sign. But as that essence becomes lighter and lighter over time, it starts to ascend towards Pisces, the 12th house of devotion, godly devotion, where now Mercury, where it's known as nichta. Nichta simply means that your exaltation of Earth's intelligence is now in niche, which means you have now ascended to somewhere higher. And what usually you will see that people who have been doing it for a long, 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 long time will develop intelligence that you can only wish for. Whether it's them looking at your face and actually telling you about your life or if something's wrong with your body. Whether that person is meeting you somewhere in a crowded place while they're actually meditating in their own room, because they're creating two bodies. And especially one of the things that I'll tell you, and this came to me first. Later on, I found out, of course, by reading certain books, I'm like, of course, this is exactly what I was, you know, thinking about. But at night, what I was doing quite a bit, maybe I think this was 2017 or something, or 2016, I don't know. I was listening to, okay, I would listen to that. It's just, it's very, very, you know, high vibrational soundtrack. I don't know why. In that, but just by listening to that, okay, I got this whole focus that, you know what? Here we are trying to build spaceships to go to the moon, to go to Mars and beyond. While the modern science doesn't realize, or at least is not telling us, that our body is actually the vessel, the rocket, to go anywhere. Now forget moon and Mars. If you want to go to that earliest galaxy that was there, you can go within an instant. And the chakras through certain breathing practices, as they're becoming active, do you know what it is? It's countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, right? They do the countdown. Life imitates, you know, fantasy, and fantasy sometimes imitates life. So the countdown of the rocket, it actually is simply awakening of the chakra one by one, and that rocket fuel is that Shushumna Nadi becoming active. So once that happens, you get access to ability and that intelligence through which you can pierce through and go towards that actual source, God realization, which is again still a difficult task. Opening up chakra doesn't mean that. What it simply means, now you have opened up the actual book to study. You can't, you know, people can't even open up the book. Chakra's opening is simply opening up the book to understand God. In that process of going chapter by chapter, you attain these certain powers which are really useless, you know, but it's that ability to go anywhere, anything, any place in this world. So what happens is it becomes very important to, of course, not only do these practices, because it could take minimum of 12 years, 2 to 12 years minimum to understand and get anything. But also at the same time, when your prarabdha karmas are being burned, this is why astrology becomes so important, which is why it was important that you have to burn these karmas off if you want to go anywhere higher. This is the clogged drain you have. And once this drain is unclogged, the water will flow, prosperity will flow. And this is why it is said, and I've heard it redundantly many times, you know, from many highly realized master. One of my favorite one is actually, besides my own teacher of Kriya, one of my other favorite one is, his name is Hariharananda Paramahansa Hariharan Nanda, you know. But the thing is, I just lost my train of thought, but the thing is, especially when you are doing your practices, you will see slowly that person actually starts finding prosperity in their life. You start to work less. What happens automatically, if you go and you properly get initiated into Kriya by a master, slowly you will see that your work, that the universe says, okay, you'll start to do less work. You'll have enough to pay for your sustenance in whichever era you're living in. So this way you're not focusing on work so much, you focus on your meditation. So what happens is, actually even Yogananda said this, that when you do Kriya, automatically it allows you to do less work so you can do more of the yogas. So you find enough sustenance and prosperity in your life. So yeah, if you want to know that magical remedy that fixes everything, this is it. It's a slow process, but again, it slowly does its work. So my whole thing is to, you know, not to give you this technique, but to tell you to seek it. Because once you have sought this technique, now you truly become somebody who's ready to burn things so they can understand something higher. But again, this is why, you know, certain dashas will keep people ignorant. And when certain dasha comes in, which has lesser of that pending karma involved in it, then they suddenly change. Their ignorance changes. Somebody who hated astrology, doesn't believe in astrology, suddenly starts to get evidence of it. Suddenly starts to change mind. You know, like you will see, especially in dasha of Rahu, it's very difficult to break from mundane ignorance, meaning your mundane material world, to ascend to somewhere else. Rarely you will see that. It happens, but it's rare. So Mercury is the very first thing which is formed because your karmas are formed for it. It's like a carpenter is making the coffin for the soul. Like carpenters gets the order that, okay, ask the soul that is needs to be in this coffin. All right. So it starts, you know, chucking through the wood, making that exact perfect coffin, which is has the karma, and the soul comes in this coffin for how many years or decades. And only once the karmas are broken off, the soul can break away from that, coffin and rise up, kind of like that movie Kill Bill. I think it was Volume 1. Right when Uma Thurman is stuck in the coffin, that's exactly when I was watching it last year, just to pass some time. I'm like, yeah, that's the soul. Soul is stuck in the coffin of its nervous system, and it's trying to escape. And even then, she learned a technique, right, from her Chinese master of hitting that particular coffin in a certain way, where it will eventually break. That's what Kriya is. That's what this whole question that you asked me is. Okay? So hopefully this has helped you guys, or at least given you some curiosity towards going into learning, you know, these things like Kriya. Well, I think everybody, again, I'm going to sound like a broken record, but it would not have started for me at all if I didn't read the autobiography of a yogi. I would have still been ignorant. I would have still been all about chasing fame and chasing, likes and follows and all that. But it's from that moment, all these things just kind of like disappear. More important things came into play. More important responsibilities came into play. Okay. So anyway, guys, if you're new to my channel, subscribe below so you don't miss these type of videos. If you want to know about your pending karmas and what exactly is your pending karma, that reading you'll find here at this link, KRSchannel.com, under shop section. Otherwise, we'll see you later. Bye-bye.